commentary is from notes made by my father. Mont Saint-Michel, or St. Michael's Mount, one of the marvels of the West. And this is the little village round the mount. Practically every house is a cafe or souvenir shop. The spire rises 400 feet above the sea, and this shot is inside the cloisters. Dinard, we found one of the most attractive of French resorts. Organized games on the beach. This is our hotel garden, with the manager of the hotel posing for a photograph. Now on to Dinan, a walled city nearly 1,000 years old. Lunch, disturbed by a cow. This is Cancale. Thank you. Here we had a look at the famous oyster beds. The hermit spent his whole life carving these figures from the granite rocks. These embroidered lace caps are worn all over Brittany and are handed down from mother to daughter. Each province has its own peculiar shape. This is one of the loveliest resorts in Brittany, Perisgeiroc. We watch this religious festival, or pardon. Thank you. this small wooden statue of a saint is visited by girls who stick a pin into the nose to remind the saint that he promised to send them a husband. Note the worn nose. These pink granite rocks with their strange shapes form one of the greatest natural curiosities of Brittany. There are many of these calvaries on the side of the road. What washes whiter than elbow grease? Thank you. Here at Concarneau, we watch the sardine boats come in. As they drop their anchors, they haul down their brown sails and hoist these delicate nets, mostly coloured blue, to the masthead to dry. Wash day again. Notice the scum on the water, but the clothes appeared to be clean. The old walled town of Vannes. Lunchtime again. All the village came out when we tried to obtain milk. This is Le Pôle, claimed to be one of the most attractive resorts in Europe. Nearby are these salt marshes. The Bretons learned from the Romans how to procure salt from seawater by evaporation, and the method has been practiced here ever since. From Le Pôle, we made our way back across Brittany to the 2K aerodrome.